3, 2, 1.
Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh. So welcome to all of you to this my new amazing channel, Math Doctor. This is the lecture number 1 of Quadratic Equation, Class 10th Mathematics. In this lecture, we will discuss about solution of a quadratic equation by factorization. So this is about myself. I have qualified KBPY, ACET and NDA and pursuing bachelor's in non-medical. So now let's discuss about what you are get from my channel. We will prepare you for NTSC, Olympiads, KBPY, NDA and lot of other examinations like GATE, IIT, JAM, IIT, JEE, NEET, CSAT, SAT, prelims, CSAT and ACET and CT series. So this is Math Doctor. So let's begin.
Ready, go!
So hello guys, welcome to all of you. So let's begin with solution of a quadratic equation by factorization. So this is a topic. Consider the quadratic equation 2x squared minus 3x plus 1 equals to 0. If we replace x by 1 on the left hand side of this equation, we get replace x with the 1, then we will get 2 into 1 raised to power 2. It's actually 1 raised to power 2 and it is also 2x raised to power square. Okay, so when we multiply by this, we will get from here 2 plus 1 minus 3, which is equals to 0. So we say that 1 is a root of a quadratic equation. So any number which satisfy the that specific quadratic equation is known as its root. This means 1 is a 0 of a quadratic polynomial. We will called 1 also 0 or root. These are the two terms we use for solution of a particular quadratic equations. Either we call them roots or zeros. Okay, so in general a real number alpha is called root of a quadratic equation. It is general case. A real number alpha which satisfies the particular quadratic equation is called its root, and also known as zero, as I've told you. So ax square plus bx plus c equals 0, where a is not equal to 0. If a alpha square plus, when we put alpha in x, then we will get this particular equation. We also say that x is equal to 0, where x is equal to alpha is a solution of a quadratic equation. We will call it 0, root or solution. So alpha is a solution of a quadratic equation, or that alpha satisfy the quadratic equation. So like this one satisfy this particular quadratic equation. Here alpha is any variable, we can change its value with respect to our constants, with respect to our our quadratic equation. Okay, so we can for satisfying the value for doing left hand side equals to right hand side, we satisfy any alpha value. So note that zeros of a quadratic polynomial ax square plus bx plus c and roots of a quadratic equation are the same. So zeros and roots both are same. So that's why we called it also a zero, because the final answer of this which satisfy the root which satisfy this equation will become zero. So that's why we also called the root root 0. Okay, when we put root in this particular polynomial, then it will become equals to 0. So then we call that polynomial is the roots of the quadratic equation are the same. Zeros and roots are the same, because roots, when we put the value of roots, it becomes equals to 0. So zeros we call, also call them zeros, roots and solution. Okay, so you have observed in chapter 2 that a quadratic polynomial can have at most two zeros. So any quadratic equation can have at most two zeros. You have learned in class 11 how to factorize quadratic polynomial by separating their middle terms. We shall use this knowledge for finding the roots of a quadratic equation. This is very important, you should note that. You have learnt in class how to factorize quadratic polynomial by separating their middle terms. Okay, if you are familiar with the quadratic polynomial chapter of class 11, class 9, then you become, you find yourself easier to solve the quadratic equation. But anyways, we will discuss about everything. We shall use this knowledge for finding the roots of the quadratic equation. Okay, so let's begin how to actually solve the particular quadratic equation. So first of all, they have this is the example number 3, okay, of your NCERT book. So let's discuss it. 2x square minus 5x plus 3 by factorization. Okay, they have tell us in this lecture we will discuss about solution of a quadratic equation by factorization. Okay, so this is the one of the that way in which we solve a quadratic equation. It is one of the easiest and but not useful very much. But it is very easy, and it becomes difficult when we solved bigger equations. It's not as complicated. Means it's not lengthy. It's not lengthy. It's but hard for bigger questions. Factorization method is not successful, but we will discuss it now. This is one of the method of solving equation. So let's discuss it, how to solve by factorization a particular quadratic equation. So let's solve it. 2x square minus 5x plus 3. We have to first use the we have to factorize quadratic polynomial by separating their middle terms. Okay, we just have to split the middle term. Okay, let's say we split it like that. 2x square minus 2x minus 3x plus 3 equals to 0. As you have seen that we have just split this particular term into both terms, minus 2x and minus 3x. So when we add both, we will get minus 5. But when we multiply both these terms, you should get the multiplication of these terms. Okay, so that's why this trick is very useful. This is because you have to take common from both sides. As if you have the same multiplication of both of these terms with the multiplication of both of these terms. So when we multiply them and multiply them, we will get 6x square. 2x square into 3 equals to 6x square. Similarly, when we multiply minus 2x with minus 3x, we will again get 6x square. So that's how we split the terms. Split minus 5x into that terms whose multiplication will be multiplication of these terms. multiplication of final and last and first term. Okay, so that's why this method is not larger. This method is very smaller, and it's not that much larger, but it needs your mind. It needs your to how to actually split them. It also needs a lot of time to solve. Okay, so this method is not for doing calculation faster, calculate it faster. So, but we will discuss it now. We will discuss some other methods also in our next lecture. So, but you should must know that for solving, it is useful for solving simple equations, simple or small equations whose a, b, c, and this a and b are comparable. Okay, like we can use it in my we can split in it like easily, split it easily for satisfying the property. Okay, we can split it easily like these terms, we can split it easily. Okay, but also by satisfying the properties that multiplication of these two terms should be multiplication of both splits of the middle term. Middle term is minus 5x, and minus we split it into minus 2 minus, then again just this is here our sum is actually ends, here our answer is actually end. Just now we have to take common 2x from both of them, both of first terms. Okay, what we get? X minus 1. Okay, x minus 1, and similarly from here we will get we will take common minus 3, and there we also get x minus 1 common. So these should be same. Okay, these should be same, these will be same when we use the right property for splitting these terms. Okay, so this is the case. So now you can take common x minus 1 from both of them, x minus 1 from both of them. Okay, now then you will get 2x minus 3 and these are the two equations. Then we will equate both of them one by one equals to 0 for getting two particular answers. Okay, one from each. Okay, this is this our first zero comes out, our first root comes out x equals to 1. Similarly when we equate second equals to 0, then we will also get x equals to 3 by 2. Okay, then we will get x equals to 3 by 2. Now these are the two roots that we get after solving this. Okay, they have tell us to find the roots, so we have done that. So let's first split the middle term minus 5, because so we have to notice, you are noticing that they split middle terms like that, that the multiplication comes out, the multiplication of first and last term. Okay, similarly then we will just, when we split these terms, then take common from both sides, and these for checking you should after it you can notice that there are common by taking common you will get again common, then you will get this. Okay, then finally you can write it equals to zero. Okay, if it is equals to zero we have given, so in this way you can, so the values of the are the same for which either 2x minus 3 equals 0 or x minus 1 equals 0 as we have done. So in this way we will get two values of x equals to 3 by 2 and x equals to 1 are the solution of the equation. Solutions means also known as roots or zeros. Okay, so 1 and 3 by 2 are the roots of the particular equation. So in this way we are ending our this question. So let's move further. Let's move on second question. Note that we have found the roots of a 2 into by factorizing into 2 linear and equating each factor to 0. Okay, so let's move further. Let's discuss another question. This is also very simple question, very simple question. So similarly you can see that you have to solve it like that, such that first of all you have to find the multiplication of first and last term, which comes out you should take consideration minus sign also. Okay, so it's come out to be minus 12x square multiplication of first and last term. Then you have to split this term such that their multiplication into two numbers, such that their that two numbers when you split when you get by splitting this term, their multiplication should be equal to this. Okay, the splitting terms multiplication should be equal to this. So let's split into like that, minus 4x plus 3x. Okay, minus 4x plus 3x. So in this way you have got that it's very easy thing. You can also split minus x into minus 2x plus x, minus 2x plus x, but it doesn't make sense any, because we want then a multiplication also equals to minus 12x square. So you have to split the middle term such that its multiplication, the multiplication of both split both splitting terms are must be this. Okay, that you have find initially when you multiply first and last term, you have got minus 12x square. So you have to notice that these two splits are also possible of middle term, but why you have done this? You can also do like this, minus x equals to minus 3x plus 2x. Okay, so this multiplication is also possible, but it again make no sense because their multiplication don't comes out to be minus 12x square. So you have to split that the middle term like their multiplication should be equals to this, that we solve initially before we approach the question. So you have to multiply first of all, write this term in the right hand side. Okay, so that you can split easily in a right way, in a proper direction. Okay, so after it you can just take common from both sides, ओके, यू हैव स्प्लिट इट करेक्टली, देन यू कैन टेक कॉमन. व्हेन यू टेक कॉमन यू अगेन गेट बोथ थिंग्स कॉमन. ओके, फॉर देन यू कैन इक्वेट दिस पर्टिकुलर पॉलिनोमियल टू फॉर्म अ इक्वेशन टू इक्वल्स टू जीरो. ओके, देन दीज टू, इफ दिस इज इक्वल्स टू जीरो देन इट इज इक्वल्स टू दिस, सो दिस कैन ऑल्सो बी इक्वल्स टू जीरो. सो इन दैट वे यू कैन फाइंड दैट एक्स इज इक्वल्स टू 2/3 एंड एक्स इक्वल्स टू -1/2. ओके, सो दिस इज हाउ यू अप्रोच द क्वेश्चन एंड सॉल्व इट इन अ वेरी इजी मैनर, इन अ वेरी स्लो, इन अ वेरी फ्यू स्टेप्स. ओके, सो बट वेन यू डू मोर प्रैक्टिस यू विल गेट मोर कॉन्फिडेंस अबाउट दिस टॉपिक. सो यू हैव टू सॉल्व अ लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस. ओके, सो इन दिस वे यू हैव गॉट दीज रूट्स. ओके, सो लेट्स मूव टू अवर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ द डे. Let's see it. Now, how to approach this particular question? Find the roots of this equation. 3x square minus 2 root 6x plus 2 equals to 0. Okay. So, before approaching this question, before trying to split the middle term, let's first of all write the multiplication of first and last term, which comes out to be 6x square. Okay, which comes out to be 6x square. So we have to multiply, when we multiply that both splits, we should get this particular term. Okay, so this particular solution by multiplying. Okay, so let's split minus 2 under root 6x into any two terms such that the multiplication comes out to be 6x square. So when we when you will see that you will multiply root 6 into root 6 and also minus, or so that the sum becomes minus root 2 minus 2 root 6. Okay, as you see their multiplication comes out to be 6. Okay, and you have x is obviously x will come. Okay, when you x is sure, so when you solve this equation, this is plus minus, actually minus, when you minus both of them, what you will get? So when you multiply both terms, you will get 6x square definitely. When you add or subtract, when you add actually both minus sums, then you will get minus 2 root 6x. So that's how you can split it correctly, split it well, okay, in a right direction. So let's solve. When you split it into these terms, okay, you will get, note that you can get common from both sides. X can be taken as common, and the next thing that you can take common is under root 3. Okay, is under root 3, and under root 3 will remain here for their sum is 3. Okay, and the multiplication is 3, for the multiplication is 3x square. Okay, so similarly when you root 6 can be written as root 3 into root 2. Okay, so as you see that you can take common easily. So this is how you can approach the you can take again take common. Okay, when you take common from root 2, you can multiply it with root 3x minus root 2. You will get 2. That's obviously. So, again, when you take common root 3x minus 2 into root 3x minus 2, it will definitely becomes equals to equals to 0. Okay. So when it becomes equals to 0, when you equate with as it is equals to 0, this can also be becomes equals to 0. Okay, then you will get that x equals to root 2 by 3. Okay, root 2 by root 3. Okay, because this is equals to 0 and x should be equals to root 2 by root 3. So that's how you can solve the question easily. So these are the two roots. Okay, this can also gives us same root, both gives us same root. Okay, this is because we will discuss this, how sometimes you get different roots and sometimes you get same roots and two roots. Okay, so this root is repeated twice, one for each factor. Okay, so 2 by root 3 comma root 2 by root 3, you should say that there are two roots for quadratic equation because this higher power is square. So for a square you must have two roots. Okay, its higher power is make this equation to cubic, add something else like 4x cube. Okay, then you will get this becomes cubic. So when you solve this equation, you will definitely get three different roots. Okay, so we will discuss about how different roots are come and how actually same roots are come, the conditions that applied for the same roots and different roots. We will discuss it later. Now let's focus on let's solve the next equation. Find the dimension of a prayer hall discussed in section 4.1. Okay, as it is the question that we have discussed earlier in the previous lecture, we have find this equation at the final. We just have to calculate the equation. Okay, in this question, just we have to solve it now correctly. We just have to told that to solve this equation. Okay, 2x square plus x minus 300. Okay, for that we will just first of all multiply 300 into 2x square, so we will get then 600x square. It is minus, so we have to consider the minus sum also, minus sign also, so it's become minus 600x square. Okay, so we have to split x such that the multiplication becomes minus 600x square. So what can we do with it? For an example, we can multiply it like that. Not 100 into 6, 100 into 6 become minus 100 into 6 will not make sense because its sum should not be equal to 1. Okay, and similarly minus 25 into 24 can be okay. As you know, first split into easier one, 100 into 6. Let's try to split into 100 into 6, 600 into minus 100 into 6, we can apply minus in any side. So you can notice that minus 25 into 4, we can split 400 and also 6. 6 can written as like that, such that there's some minus 25 into 24. So we have to take minus 1 for any one number, such that their sum is, such that their multiplication is 1, minus actually. Okay, and their sum is, we have to check the convenience sign for which we have to take, such that their sum is 1. Okay, such that their sum is 1. So for that we should take 25 minus 25, as their sum, as their multiplication will definitely become same as this, as the multiplication of this, na? So it is become actually minus 600. We have to check the convenient sign for which we have to take. Okay, so in this way we can submit x 25 x minus, now we can put x minus 24x. So that's how we split these terms. Okay, so when you write it here, you can write it like that, minus 24x plus 25x. Okay, or 25x minus 24x, both are same things. Okay, we because we have to take common 2 from here and x, so that's why we use this term here for taking, such that 2 can come out from here when we take common. So 2 can come from both these terms, 2 can 2 can become common from both these terms, 2x can be common, so x should, as x will obviously common. So when we take 2x common, then we will left with x minus 12. Okay, and we take, then we will definitely take 25 common from minus 300, where when we multiply 25 into 12, we will get, as we get 25 into 24 equals to 600, then we will definitely get 25 into 12 equals to minus 300. So that's how you can split, then again take common x minus 12, then x minus 12 into 2x plus 5 will become equal to 0. So that's how you solve this question. So the roots of the given equation are x minus 12 equals to 0. We will separately write it 0, so that we will get two roots. First we get x equals to 12, and second one we get 2x equals to minus 25. Okay, when 25 will go into this side. Okay, we are actually solving it separately, so x will definitely become minus 25 by 2. 25 by 2 is nothing but 12.5. okay, so minus sign is there, so we will write x equals to minus 12.5. okay, so that's how we write both roots. So since x is the breadth of the hall, as we have discussed earlier, we let x as the breadth of the hole, it cannot be negative, so we ignore this answer. Okay, then x is equal to 12 of our answer, thus breadth is definitely becomes, then its breadth will definitely becomes 12, and its length will become and its length will become 2x plus 1 equal plus 1, which is equal to 25. Okay, as x is 12 into 2 plus 1 equals to 25. We have this is the question that we have solved for length and breadth when we have given the relationship between them, that length is twice the breadth, one more, length is one more than twice the breadth. Okay, you should remember this. In the previous lecture we have discussed it very deeply. So this is the equation that we have that we find. Then in this lecture we are solving its roots. What are the values that x can get? Okay. So as you see, this x, this equation can also take the value of x negative. Yes, x negative can be possible. You will realize it when you study complex numbers. How negative is possible? How complex number can be possible? Means imaginary numbers can be possible. So for that purpose we are leaving it now for you homework. I will give you some homework questions yet right now, for instance. So you should solve the homework, not all questions, but I will recommend you to solve these statement questions. But you can still solve it easily, every question. Yeah, definitely. So try to solve and make sure that for any doubts you can ask me in my Telegram channel Math Doctor. Okay, so in this way we are ending our lecture. Please like, comment and share my channel to your friends. For notes, assignments, follow my Telegram channel Math Doctor. Okay, follow me on Instagram and Telegram. Thank you. Vaheguru ji ka khalsa, Vaheguru ji ki fateh.